Hi my dear friends, my name is Abhishek and you are watching Maths Magic channel on YouTube. Today we are going to discuss about the topic number 1.5, that is operations on real numbers. In the theory, they have told us about the properties of rational numbers, that is rational numbers satisfy the property of commutative law, the property of associative law or distributive law, or in simple words we can say the rational number satisfies the property of commutativity, associativity and distributivity. Now, four things they have mentioned in the theory, that is whenever two rational numbers are added, their answer will be rational number. Whenever rational numbers are subtracted, their answer will be rational number. Whenever two rational numbers are multiplied, their answer will be rational number, except zero, that is the condition here. And whenever two rational numbers are divided, then the answer is real rational number except zero. So this is the property about rational number. Then irrational numbers property are discussed. Irrational number also satisfy the property of or the law of commutativity, associativity and distributivity, or they satisfy these all the three properties of numbers. Now they are discussing about the special cases. Whenever two irrational numbers are added, the answer is rational. It is not irrational like we have seen in the rational numbers. Here in rational number, addition of two rational number is rational, this subtraction is rational, addition multiplication of two rational number is rational, and division of two rational number is rational. But special cases are there in the irrational number. Addition of two irrational number leads to the rational number. The subtraction of two irrational numbers lead to the answer as rational number. Multiplication of two irrational numbers lead to answer as rational number. And division of two irrational number leads to the answer as rational number. So these are the four special cases. On the basis of this, they have discussed the two statements. These two statements means rational number plus irrational number is answer is irrational number, and rational number into irrational number is irrational number. Then they have discussed about the example number 12. Check whether 7 root 5 comma 7 upon root 5 comma root 2 plus 21 comma pi minus 2 are irrational numbers or not. They are telling us to check whether all these values are irrational numbers or not. First we will write the value of root 5, that is 2 4 2 3 6 3 dots. So it means it will continue. Root 2 is 1.414 3 dots and pi is 3.1415. 7 root 5 means 7 is rational number while root 5 is irrational number. 7 rational number into irrational number, the answer is irrational. So 7 into 2.236, the value of root 5, the answer is 15.652 dots. It means that it is non-terminating and non-recurring number, so it is irrational number. Then second is 7 upon root 5. 7 upon root 5 means when we rationalize the ratio, we get 7 upon root 5 into root 5 into root 5. So the numerator is 7 into root 5 and denominator is root 5 into root 5, that is 5. So we know that 7 root 5 is 15.652 from here, and in the denominator 5 is there. So 15.652 dot 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 upon 5, that the answer is 3.1304 3 dots. So this is also non-terminating and non-recurring, so irrational number. Third is root 2 plus 21. Root 2, we know that 1 plus 4 1 4 2 plus 21, so answer is 22 plus 22.4142. This is also non-terminating and non-recurring, so it is irrational number. And the last one is pi minus 2, that is 3.1415 minus 2, that is 1.1415 dots. This is also non-terminating and non-recurring, so it is also called as the irrational number. So on the basis of the above calculation, we come to know that all these numbers are non-terminating, non-recurring decimal expansion. So all these are irrational numbers. Then we are discussing example number 13. Example number 13 is add 2 root 2 plus 5 root 3 and root 2 minus 3 root 3. 2 root 2 plus root 2, that is 3 root 2. and 5√3 minus 3√3, that is 2√3. This is the answer. Or you can also solve as the method I will discuss here. Put √2 √2 term side by side and √3 √3 term side by side. So we will get 2√2 plus √2, that is 3√3. 5√3 minus 3√3, that is 2√3. Then example number 14. Multiply 6√5 by 2√5. We have to multiply these two numbers. 6 2s are 12 and √5 into √5, that is 5. 12 5s are 60. This is the answer. Divide 8√15 by 2√3. So 8 by 2 means 4 and √15 is √3 into √5. √3 √3 are cancelled. So answer is 4√5. So on the basis of all the three examples, example number 13, 14 and 15, we come to the point or the conclusion that rational number plus irrational number, the answer is irrational number. Rational number minus irrational number, answer is irrational number. Rational number into irrational number, answer is irrational number. Rational number divided by irrational number, answer is irrational number. Irrational number, and the last statement is the sum, difference or subtraction, multiplication and division of irrational number with irrational number. The answer may be rational or irrational also. So here our topic number 1.5 is completed with example number 12, 13, 14 and 15. In the next topic, we will discuss about this, how to find the square root of real numbers. Thank you and have a nice day, my dear friends.